Hello, in this video I'm going to do a playthrough of the tabletop version of the solitary game Bismarck, which was released in 2021 as a book game by Worthington. I have included in this version the manual of the board game version of this game, which came out in 2023, so the rules are actually identical. As for the book game, the only difference is that in this physical board game version there are 18 different missions, while in the original book game there were only 9. And probably this is because in this Solitaire Deluxe Edition board game there also the Battle of Denmark is included, which is a separate map. As you can see, there are 7 pages of rules, so this is not a complex game. Not a very complex game. It's quite easy to learn, actually. Also, the difference with my version is that I don't use the cubes to indicate the view. As you can see, the cube, I've replaced the cubes with discs. This is not a major difference. I also use a pawn as turn indicator, but this is not a real difference. And the complexity is a bit in how to apply the rules under certain conditions, so sometimes you have to go back to the rule book to check out how certain rules, how certain events have to be applied in certain situations. And to aid in that, I have also included a page which was a deduction from Board Game Geek, where is listed some of the interpretations that should be made about how to implement certain events, and hopefully this will clarify or help to clarify how to implement the rules under certain conditions. Okay. The first thing we have to do is selecting a mission, and as mentioned, the rulebook contained 9 different missions. The first one is actually more a training mission, which can be used as an introduction to the game. And as you can see on the top right corner, this is labeled as easy. And we can select various missions by clicking on with the right mouse button. Here we are selecting mission number 2, which is also an easy mission. We can also use the number keys on our keyboard to go to mission number 3. Then we have mission number 4, and here we already see the start of missions which are a bit more difficult. Mission number 5, mission number 6. Then we have mission number 7. From there we have the difficulty hard, which is also the case for mission 8 and mission 9. So it goes gradually up in difficulty level. But for this playthrough, I'm going to play the second mission, which is an easier mission. And if we look at the objectives on the top left corner, there's a short description of the objectives. We have to make our way to the main shipping lanes and find the target and sink it. And most importantly, we have to return the Bismarck, which is our main battleship, safely to the port of Bergen or Brest. And if we look at the game board, the port of Bergen is located here in Norway, while the port of Brest is located here in the south, on the coast of France. If we look on the top right corner, the win conditions, we have to earn 3 or more victory points and return the Bismarck to Bergen or Brest after turn 16. And we can also even earn a medal when we return our second battleship, the Prince Eugen, to port Bergen or Brest after turn 16 also. And how can we earn victory points? We can see that on the ship status board, that we can earn 1 victory point for each convoy that we sink. So only with 1 hit we can sink a convoy. So these are relatively easy targets. But we also have the battleships here. We can earn victory points with. If we sink the HMS King George V, we can earn 4 victory points, which is indicated here with the white number on the grey background. For the hood, we can earn 3 victory points, for the repulse 2, and so on. And another way to earn victory points is by doing certain events, like this one here. If we have a U-boat in that particular zone, and this event is applicable during that turn, then if we manage to sink the Ark Royal, we can also earn 2 victory points. And these victory points will be added, or will be indicated here on this extra field. And we can earn in this way up to maximum 5 victory points. So while we're at it, we can also have a look at our fleet. We have at our disposal, obviously, the Bismarck, which is our main battleship, also the strongest one. As you can see, it has a firepower of 3, which is indicated here in the orange field. The Prince Eugen only has a firepower of 2. The speed of the maximum speed is can go up to 2 for the Bismarck, so that means that he can move up to 2 spaces, while the Prince Eugen can move up to 3 spaces. So this ship is less powerful in terms of firepower, but it's more quicker on the game board. And then we also have in support the U-boat, which has a firepower of 1 and a maximum speed of 1. We can per turn spend 1 fuel, and for the Bismarck we have 4 available, which allows us to increase the speed with 1. So we can go up to 3 speed by spending 1 of these fuel marks. And the same goes for the Prince Eugen. He can, during a turn, go even to speed 4 if he spends 1 fuel marker. But he only has 2, while the Bismarck has 4. And here we see the same for the U-boat. He can go up to speed of 2 by spending 1 of his fuel markers. And then last but not least is the strength of the ship. It's represented by this bar. It's can call it the hull strength. It's actually a kind of health bar. So the strength here starts at 11. And every time that the Bismarck would take a hit, the strength will go down until it's lower than 1. And it's reached 0. The Bismarck is sunk. And this X here indicates that we lost the game. While if the Prince Eugen is sunk, we do not necessarily lose the game, but we will lose 3 victory points. And the same goes for the U-boat. We will also lose victory points, but we only will lose 1 victory point. So as you can see, the strength of the Prince Eugen is 6, maximum strength, and the U-boat only has a strength of a mere 3. Then our opponent, the Royal Navy, also have several ships. As we can see here, the firepower of the HMS King George is also 3, like the Bismarck. The hood also has a firepower of 3, the repulse 2, and so on. And then we also have various strengths. So King George V has a strength of 9, the hood 7, the repulse 7, and so on. Convoys are a bit special. They only have a strength of 1 and 0 firepower, so they can't fire back. And so this should be relatively easy to kill. But the thing is to find them. That is the task. Okay, so once we have selected our mission, the next thing we have to do is to determine the starting location of our ships. So here we have our battleship fleet, which is represented, the Bismarck is represented by this block here, and also the Prince Eugen, while the U-boat is represented by this block. And the starting position for our battleships is in one of these grids, so A5, A6, A7, or A8. and they can choose any one of the movement squares, and they can even be in the same movement square. The starting position for the battleships is also indicated on the player 8, so the first line, the Bismarck and Prince Eugen, can start at A5 until A8. And when they are in the same movement square, they are considered together. They can, and also when they are in the same grid, in this case the grid A5, they also considered together, operating together, so they will also fight together. From the moment they are in different grids, like is the case here, the Bismarck is in A5 and the Prince Eugen in A6 and the Prince Eugen is in A5 grid, then they are considered separated. And then the rules are a bit different. In that case, the enemy will focus on the Bismarck. And they will not fight together. So, being together has certain advantages, of course, especially in sea battles. But sometimes can also be a disadvantage, because certain effects can then apply to both ships if they are together. And we will see that maybe during the playthrough. But most of the time I will keep them together. Just for the sake of example, we will put them maybe in... the Bismarck is the slowest one, so we put it here, and then the Prince Eugen next to it. This will be our starting position for this game. Then we have the U-boat. The U-boat can be placed in any row, can start in in any row, but in the columns 1 to 4. So actually it can be placed in any one of these four columns on any row. And we are going to put it on A4. And why do we do that? Because, as we can see here, there is an event where there is a convoy, a battleship and a convoy, but we can attack this convoy if this event shows up, and we see that this will be in the area of Echo Foxtrot, in the orange area. So if we put our submarine in ambush there and this event shows up, we can attack the convoy and hopefully gain an easy victory and get a victory point. So that's why we put it here in ambush, in waiting, in this Echo 4 area at the start of the game. And then the game starts. And the sequence of play is indicated on the board game. First, there are 6 steps, actually. The first one is to roll 2 dice to determine the event that is applicable for that turn. And we are in turn, we start in turn number 1. And then we see that first, depending on the event, we have to resolve air attacks first, then U-boat attacks, then resolve ship combat, and then the 5th step is to move our ships, and the sixth step is to mark the turn and repeat the sequence. So the first thing we have to do is to roll 2 dice to determine the event. And we do this by using the black and the white die, put them in the dice roll area, and click on the roll dice, and there we see a white 3 and a black 6, and this will determine the event. And we have a white 3 and a black 6, and this is the home fleet event. You can see here, this is this event, and sometimes during the game, to avoid losing track of which event is applicable, we can use one of these active event markers. I prefer to use this one, but you can also use this event marker. Especially during ship combat, it can be handy to otherwise we sometimes lose track of the event that is ongoing, especially if we use all dice during combat. So to indicate this, I put this active event marker over it. But here we see that this event states that the home fleet is operating in this red area. So first we have a look at our U-boat, which is in Echo 4. And this is outside this area. If we would have been inside the area, we could have decided to attack, which would not be a clever decision, but okay, it's outside the area, and also our fleet in Alpha 5 is outside this red area. It's over here, so there is no particular event that has to be applied. So that means that no air attacks, there is also no U-boat attack, no ship combat, and we can immediately move to step number 5, moving our ships. And what we are going to do is going to maneuver more to this area, because there is one of the events where we also have a ship repair area. So it's always useful to be in that neighborhood if we would encounter some enemy battleships and we would have some damage. So I'm moving now 2 steps, which is the maximum speed of the Bismarck. And here we have Prince Eugen following. We can even put it in the same spot here, because he has a maximum speed of 3. And up. The U-boat will stay on its location in ambush. And then we have to do the 6th step, mark the turn. And we do this by clicking on the turn marker. And now we start turn 2. This is also indicated with the turn marker here on the game board. Okay, turn number 2. We have to do the same as to roll the dice to determine the event during the second turn. And now we have a white 6 and a black 3. So actually we are over here, a white 6 and a black 3. And here we see that we are actually in this ship repair event. But our ships are not there, and we also have no damage for the moment, so the ship repair is not active. But there is this event here in the light blue zone, the swordfish attack. And luckily, we look first at Echo 4, although this U-boat is within this zone, this event is only applicable to ships, because one of the rules is that U-boats cannot be attacked by aircraft except if it's explicitly stated in the event. As you can see here in the rule book, page 3, the U-boat is treated differently than ships because it has the ability to submerge. Events that refer to effects on ships apply only to the Bismarck and Prince Eugen. Any events that apply to the U-boat will state such. There are examples of that where the U-boat is specifically stated, like for instance here in this event. Here the U-boat is specifically stated, British bomber, so it can be attacked by air, but only in specific situations. This is not the case here. And this is one of the difficulties sometimes in the game, how to interpret the rules. So this is how it has to be interpreted. So the fuel leak and loss of all extra fuel is only applicable to ships who are in this blue area. And fortunately, our ships here are in Alpha 4. So this is just outside this area. Otherwise, we would have lost all our fuel on the Bismarck and on the Prince Eugen, because they are together. This is one of the disadvantages of being sometimes together, that this bad event is applicable to both ships. But fortunately for us, this is not the case. So also this event has no impact, and we can move immediately to step number 5. And then continue our voyage. And then we take the Prince Eugen 1, 2, 3. This is maximum speed. Here we can, oh, this is the Bismarck, sorry. 1, 2, 3, and to do this, we have to spend 1 fuel. So this is also demonstrating the increased speed for the Bismarck that we can apply. 1, 2, 3, this is his standard maximum speed, so the Prince Eugen has no problem following the Bismarck. We leave the U-boat over there, and then we mark our next turn, which is the start of turn 3. And in the meantime, we know the drill. We have to roll the black and the white dice to determine which event will be applicable. We can also do this manually. And now we have the event 1. 1, the double 1. And this is the upper left event. This is the active event for Force H from Gibraltar, but our U-boat is at Echo 4, so it's outside the area. And also our battleships here at Bravo 3 are outside this event zone, so nothing happens. Mind you that this is one of the events that if you are confronted with it, you have to take care, because as you can see, the air attack is the first action you have to do. You have to apply the air attack first, but you should not forget that there's also one battleship there. So that is sometimes forgotten by the players, that they do the air attack and then they move on. No, there's also a battleship there. So if you have battleships there, you also have to fight the Renome. And this is often forgotten because the ship combat is after the air attack. But we are not in that area. We are not anywhere near it, so it's not applicable to our ships. So again, we can move further. So we're going to move here with the Bismarck 2 spaces. The Prince Eugen is following. And then we move to turn 4. Okay, again we are going to roll to determine the event for this turn. Now we have a white 6 and a black 2. So we are actually again over here. And this means again that there is no event because we are in Bravo 2 outside the green area. Also the blue is not applicable to the U-boat. So again we jump to move step 5, moving our battleships. We are going to move south because in the end we want to head back to Brest after turn 16. Then we move on turn number 5 and again do a roll of the dice. 5 and 3, a white 5 and a black 3, and now we are in this event over here. White 5, black 3, just to check if I'm correct. Yeah. And now we have these areas, but I think we are still outside. Let's look for, so we are in Echo 4 with the U-boat, but again, these are airplane attacks and the U-boat is not specifically mentioned. So it's only applicable to our ships, and our ships are in Charlie 2. And Charlie 2 is outside this event areas, so there is no immediate impact. So again, we can move. We're going to move further south. Maybe also come into this orange zone if this event will pop up. Maybe we can also then contribute in killing off a convoy, or maybe even one of the battleships. And so we moved, yes, and then we have to go for the next turn. It's turn number 6. Again, we are going to roll the event dice. A white 2 and a black 6. A white 2 and a black. This is in the bottom here, bottom left corner. And here we are probably getting interesting. We are here in a zone where a lone warship is operational. Let's first look at the U-boat, because the U-boat is first in line for any attacks. He can decide himself if he attack or not. Echo 4. Echo 4 is in the orange zone, so it's the zone where the Rodney is. And also our battleships are over there, Delta 2 or not? Yes, Delta 2, we are also in the orange zone, so we are confronted with the Rodney. But if the U-boat decides to attack the Rodney in order to support our fleet, the Rodney is over here, has a firepower of 3. So this is not not a low firepower. So I can decide to attack this battleship. And as can be seen here on the player 8, the second last line, the U-boat is not affected by air attacks or ship combat, but the U-boat can decide to attack, and that means he can hit the target with a roll of 1 to 3, but if he does a roll of 4 to 6, the U-boat will suffer a hit. But we can decide to attack or not. If we do nothing, then we just stay there and nothing happens, but we decide to attack the Rodney, because we are in the area of the Rodney, so we are going to do a die roll and hope for the best. So the U-boat is now attacking, and he has a 2, he has a hit, as indicated here on the player 8, and that means that the Rodney, the strength of the Rodney is down from 7 to 6. And now it's now that we have completed the U-boat attack, we are going to ship combat. And as can be seen also on the player 8, the fourth line in ship combat, the German player fires first. So we are the first one to open fire. But before we do that, we have the option to use a certain battle tactic. So just for matter of illustration, I'm going to apply the long range tactic for the Bismarck, where he can try to avoid some damage. For this he has to roll with one die. It can be seen here. Keep your distance from the enemy ships. He can win the fact that he can ignore one, the first hit on his ship, if he rolls 1 to 3, but at the cost of a firepower. So let's roll the die. He has a 3, as can be seen here. Remove one die of your ship's firepower, but ignore the first hit on your ship in this battle round. And to have a reminder of this, we mark the Bismarck with this ignore one hit token, and now we can fire at the Rodney, but we can only fire with, normally we can fire with 3, but we, because of this long range ship tactic, we have to remove one of the die. So we only have 2, so we're going to fire at the Rodney, and we have a 3 and a 6, and as can be seen here, we have a hit when we roll 1 to 3, or a miss for a 4 to 6 roll. So that means we have one hit on the Rodney, and the roll takes one hit. Goes down in strength with one, and now is the turn on for the Prince Eugen to fire at the enemy. Prince Eugen, for illustration, we will choose this close-in battle tactic, and depending on the roll, this will add one firepower, but maybe at the cost of a hit to our own ship. So we are also going to do one roll for this ship tactic. We roll a 2. This is very good. We add one die to our firepower this round. So instead of 2, we can use 3 dice. And now we're going to fire at the Rodney. And we have 2 hits. One miss, the blue, and the 2 hits, the black and the red. So that means that the Rodney is losing 2 strength. And now we are finished with the German round. And now it's the enemy is going to fire at us. The enemy has a firepower of 3, so that means that he's going to use 3 dice to fire at the Bismarck. And this is one of the rules, that the first ship, but there is only one here, will always fire at the Bismarck. The second most powerful ship in terms of firepower will fire at the Prince Eugen, and then all the other ships, if there are more than 2, will fire at the Bismarck. But okay, here we only have one enemy ship, so he will be firing at the Bismarck, because this is the main target for the British. And here we see that he only scores one hit. And this hit is even not applied, because we have the battle tactics of long range, and we can ignore one hit. So this token is used, not to forget that. And so actually, very good result for us. Now we go to the second round, and from the second round, the player has the option to use not only a battle tactic, but also from the second round, after the first round, he can choose to escape the battle, especially if the battle is not going well, by rolling a die. But this we will not do, because we are in a very good position of sinking the Rodney and obtaining these 3 victory points, which is one of our objectives of this game, so of this mission. So we are going to continue, but also the British will try to escape. And here it's stated on the game board, the British escape or remain decision. All British ships stay in ship combat if the groups, so all British ships' total current strength exceeds the German ships' group's total current strength. Otherwise, if that is not the case, all British ships will try to escape after the first round. So the first round they have to fight, but after the first round they can decide to, or they can try to escape by doing one die roll. And they only do that when their ship strength, total ship strength, is lower than ours, which is the case, because their ship strength is only 3, while our total ship strength is 11 plus 6 is 17. So they definitely will try to escape. So that is done also by one roll of the die, and he rolls a 4. And as you can see here, on a roll of 4 to 6, they all must stay for another round of ship combat. So that's good for us. And now again, the Bismarck will open fire on the Rodney. I will not use any battle tactic, because this is optional, to close in or to do long range. I could use close in to get another firepower, so I could increase it until firepower 4, and then I can throw it all 4 dice, but I don't think this is really necessary for this battle. And you also see then if you use all four dice that sometimes you can lose track of the event. That's why I mark it here. Okay, but we are not going to use any special tactic. So we are going to use our full firepower of 3 to fire at Rodney. So we roll the dice. And we have no hit. 3 misses. Okay, so it's up to the Prince Eugen now. The Prince Eugen only has a firepower of 2. We could increase it. But the Rodnir still has a strength of 3. So we will first try to close in with the Prince Eugen. So for that we have to roll with 1 die. He has a 5. Receive 1 hit, but add 1 die to your ship's firepower this round. So we get an extra firepower, so we can roll with 3 dice, but at the cost of 1 hit to our ship. Strength. Now we are going to fire at Rodney. And hopefully he will do better than the Bismarck. And he has 2 hits. 1 miss. So the Rodney is still in business. Still not destroyed. Now the Rodney will fire back at the Bismarck with a firepower of 3. So to put the dice back. Now the Rodney will fire. And he scores 2 hits. And this time we cannot ignore them. Because we did not select a special long range tactic. So he loses 2 strength points. And now we are again in the situation where we have to decide if we want to escape or not. We will not do that because he is almost destroyed. But of course he will try to escape. Because obviously his strength is much lower than our combined strength. So we are again in this situation here where the British will try to escape. Hopefully they cannot do it because then I lose my opportunity to sink their ship. So I roll the die, a 6, and we are lucky. He must stay in for another round of ship combat. Now we really should finish him off. Okay, so the Bismarck again will open fire. It are using 3 dice. And there we go. Not going to use any special battle tactic. And there we have it. We have 2 hits. So that means that the Rodney is sunk. And we scored our first victory points. 3 victory points are now already achieved due to this sea battle. So that finishes the sea battle, because there was only 1 enemy battleship. So step 4 is finished. Then we go to step 5, move our ships. And because we are a bit damaged, we are going to move into this area here. Bismarck 2 steps, and also the Prince Eugen. And hopefully this event will show up and then we have the opportunity to repair our ships. The U-boat stays where it is, and then we mark the turn and repeat the sequence. So we go now to the start of turn number 7. So we're doing quite well. And we also demonstrated how a ship battle took place. So it was a very useful event there. So for turn number 7, the event that we have is white 5 and a black 6. White 5, black 6 is over here. And here we have also battleships operating in these areas. So we first look at our U-boat, which is in Echo 4. That's over here, so he's in the area where the Hood and the Prince of Wales are operating, but he will not attack them because that would be, it would make no much sense. We have a risk of damaging ourselves, so we want to score ahead to easier targets, which are here, that convoy. So we are not going to attack. And also our battleships are outside the zone, so in Delta 1. So they are not, they are over here, so they are not impacted by the zone. So we can move to step number 5. Move the ships, so we're going to go a bit further south. Because we eventually want to get to Brest after turn 16. And then we go to the next turn. And again, we have to roll for the event that is applicable during turn number 8, which is a white 5 and a black 4. A white 5 and a black 4 is the same event, nothing changes. So, again, no difference. We again move further south, continue our voyage, and we go to turn 9, and hopefully this event will show up. Let's do a manual roll to change. There we have a white 2 and a black 5. A white 2 and a black 5. We are again in this event. But as we can see, we are with the U-boat inside the orange area E4. But this is the area of the Rodney, and the Rodney is already destroyed. So here, if the Rodney would still be alive, this would be an opportunity for the U-boat to finish it off. But if he would have had escaped the previous battle. But this is not necessary, so there is no enemy ship over there anymore. And our fleet is also outside these areas, Foxtrot 1, so there is no impact. Okay, then let's move just one space. Go to the next turn, turn number 10, and determine the event for that turn. White 1, the black 3. This is again this event, but also here we are outside this area because Echo 4 is where the U-boat is, and we are over here. Thinking, what was it? Yeah, it was Golf 1. So again, no action. Now we have to decide if we're still moving or not. We could already start moving to Brest, but I think I will wait one turn because this will take us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we still have some time. We have to reach it before the end of turn 20, because otherwise, as you can see here on the player rate, the bottom, the British automatically win when the Bismarck is sunk, or at the end of turn 20 without the Bismarck in their home port. But we still have time, so we will wait here a bit to see if we can get those repairs. We go to turn number 11. See here, also here, and now we are going to decide on the event during that turn. A white 5 and a black 2, a white 5 and a black 2. This is this event. White 5, black 2, is this correct? Just check, double check. Yeah. Okay, we are here in Golf 1, and we are here in Echo 4 with the U-boat, but again, U-boat is not impacted by air attacks, and we are also outside this zone. So again, nothing happens. And what will we do? We will wait one more time. Maybe go. We stay where we are. We wait one more time, and then if we don't get the repair, we will have to start heading back to port. So we do another event roll. 1-1. This is again this event. So again, we are outside this zone of operations. So nothing happens. And now we have to decide what we're going to do, and now we're going to start heading back at our port, moving at a speed of 2. Could have waited a bit longer because we also still have these fuel barrels to go quicker, but we will already start moving back. And then we go to the next turn, 13, and the event for 13 is a white 6 and a black 4. Oh, this is this event. White 6, black 4. We have our U-boat in Echo 4. It's not impacted because it's outside the operating area, but it's mentioned, so it could have been impacted if it would be in the operation area. And we have this fleet here, our fleet at Gulf 2, so also outside of this operating area, so no impact. Okay, slowly but surely we move forward towards the port of Brest. So here we see our boat, our ships, German fleet, and then again go to turn number 14, again roll the event dice, white 5, black 4, white 5, black 4, oh ho, this is another story. Battleships sighted. Let's first look at the U-boat Echo 4, and he is in a different zone, so he will not attack. That has no use. But this is in a different zone than our fleet. We are in Gulf 3. Gulf 3. We are here in the orange area. We are in the area of the Ramillies and the Repulse. So that means we have to do another sea battle, but this time with two enemy ships, the Ramillies and the Repulse. This one. Okay, another sea battle, and again we can start first. The Ramirez and the Repulse. So for the Bismarck, I'm going to use the ship battle tactic long range again. For this, I'm going to roll with one die four. Four, remove one die of your ship's firepower. Okay, that is a disadvantage. We could use these markers here to indicate that, but this is just a temporarily reduction. Normally, if there is an event which gives you a permanent reduction, then it's most that we will use these markers. But okay, just for demonstration, we use it during this temporary reduction of our firepower. So we are going to have to fire to one of these ships. The Ramillies seems to be the weakest one, so we are going to fire at the Ramillies first. firepower is the same for those two ships. So the Bismarck is firing at the Ramillies with only two firepower because we chose this long range strategy, but didn't turn out too well for us. But okay, we fire. And then we have one hit and one miss. The red is the hit, the blue is the miss, and that means that the Ramillies is suffering one hit. This one was temporary, so we remove it. Now it's the turn, the Prince Eugen's turn. Prince Eugen will also target the Ramillies. So he will use his firepower of two. Could he close in maybe? There's a risk that he takes hits because of doing this. But why not? We take the risk. So we roll with the dice. With the die first. We have a three. Closing in. Receive one hit but add one die for ship's firepower. So the Prince Eugen takes one hit. But now he can fire with three guns. We can roll with three dice instead of two. And all a miss. This is very unfortunate. Now is the enemy's turn. The first round they have to fight. There's no choice. So the strongest ship, both have firepower of two, but then I take the ship always with the biggest strength. So the Repulse will fire at the Bismarck and the second ship will fire at the Prince Eugen. So this is according to the rules. So the Repulse is now firing at the Bismarck. There he goes. And we get one hit. One hit on the Bismarck. Strength going down from 9 to 8. Then the Ramillies also firing with a firepower of 2. So this means 2 dice. Also one hit, but this time on the Prince Eugen. Prince Eugen is getting a bit low on strength. And now we have to decide, do we continue this battle? Or do we get out? We already have the victory points that we wanted to achieve. But just as a matter of the demonstration, we are going to continue the fight. So we are not going to try to escape. We decide to stay in the fight. Okay, the British enemy also has to make that decision. And now he has to see what is his total strength. So this is 4 plus 7 is 11. While our strength is 8 plus 3 is also 11. So we have equal strength. And what does the rune say? Oh, the ship total. The current strength exceeds the German ship's group's total current strength. So they are not exceeding. So that means that the British will also try to escape. So for that they roll one die. So just to make sure, their strength is 7 plus 4. Yeah, that's 11. We have 8 plus 3. That fits. So they will try to escape. They roll a 5 and it didn't work out. On a roll of 4 to 6, they all must stay for the another round of ship combat. Okay, the Bismarck will open fire at the Ramillies. And the Bismarck will also now try to close in, increase my firepower. So I will roll with one die. We have a 4. 4 means receive one hit but add one die to the ship's firepower. So actually, temporarily, You have a firepower of 4 now. For this round. But at the cost of 1 hit. Okay, so now we will use all 4 dice. That's why it's convenient to keep this event marker here. Because now we are losing what we have rolled with the event dice. Okay, so now we are going to fire with 4 on the Ramillies. And this is the Bismarck firing. And we have 2 hits. Red and black. And 2 misses, white and blue. That means Ramillies goes down to 2. Okay. And now is the turn of the Prince Eugen. He could also try to close in, but he's already a bit low on strength, so we're not going to risk it, and we're not going to choose any ship battle tactics because it's optional anyway. We're just going to fire away with our 2 guns. In the meantime, I'm going to remove this firepower because this was only temporarily. Going to fire at the Ramillies with the Prince Eugen. And he has 1 hit. That means that the Prince, that the Ramillies is almost destroyed, but not yet. And now is the turn of the enemy opponent. It was the Repulse. Yeah, and the Ramillies, yes. Okay, so the Repulse will now fire at the Bismarck. It's a firepower of 2. And he has scores 2 hits. The Ramillies will also fire, but he will fire at the Prince Eugen, also with a firepower of 2, as indicated here, with this black number on the orange background. And he also scores 2 hits. We're almost losing 3 victory points. So the battle is not going very well. Not for the Prince Eugen, also not so good for the Bismarck. So now I think the risk is a bit too high that we. Although. We will see. In each case, I would try to escape because we still need some strength, possibly also to get to our port. So, for the next round, round number 3 in the battle, we'll try to escape and we roll the 2, and that means escape and avoid battle. So, this escape when they are together is for both ships. Don't have to roll for each ship separately, this is also one of the rules. And with this roll we ended the ship battle because we escaped it. And that ends step 4. And now we have to continue our voyage. And we will speed up a bit maybe. 1, 2, 3 with the Prince Eugen, and 1, 2, 3 with the Bismarck using 1 extra fuel. Then we go to turn 15. Again, we have to decide on the event during this turn. And we do that by rolling the dice, the event dice, the black and white one. A white 5 and a black 4. Ooh, this is the same event. White 5, black 4. The U-boat is still in the zone of the Hood and the Prince of Wales, so no change there. But we are in the meantime, we are in goal 5. And goal 5. Ooh, this is the area of the King George and the Rodney. So that means that we now have to fight the King George and the Rodney, and these are three powerful. The Rodney are destroyed. That's fortunate. So we only have to fight the King George. But nevertheless, it's a powerful ship. Five power 3 and strength 9. But we are lucky. We are ready to counter Rodney in a previous turn. So here it goes. The Germans start first. The Bismarck will aim, obviously, at the only ship who is there, the King George V. We will not use any. We could try to increase our firepower, but that is tricky. We are already below also on the Bismarck on strength, so now we are going just to do the normal drill and fire with 3 dice to the King George. And we have 2 hits. So the King George is going down to strength 7. Then the Prince Eugen will fire. But this one will try to keep distance. Use this battle tactic, maybe at the cost of a fire. Although, the King George will fire at the Bismarck, will not fire at the Prince Eugen. Yes, so that's not really necessary. But we are not. Yeah, we are going to do the normal die roll. No, we are not going to use any battle tactic. So the Prince Eugen fires at the King George V and has 2 hits. So he's down to 5. And now is the turn for the Royal Navy. He is going to fire at the Bismarck. And here he goes. And he scores luckily only 1 hit, the black die. So the strength is going from 5 to 4. And now we have to decide if we want to escape. As we can see already here, also the enemy will have to decide to escape or not. His strength is 5. And it's the same as ours, 4 plus 5. So he will also try to escape. Because we already have achieved our victory points, would not be very clever to continue the battle, so I will try to escape. Of course, we have a risk here. Take 1 hit on each ship, and that means that we could lose the Prince Eugen. This is a bit tricky also. So we are not going to try to escape. No, we stay in the battle. But the enemy has a strength of 5, like I mentioned, it's the same as ours, our double strength. So he will also try to escape, because he is not exceeding our strength. So he will roll 1 die, and it's a 2, and that means they all escape, but there's only 1 ship there, so this is the end of the battle. And the British warship has escaped. Okay, so that was the end. So we're still not there, we still have to try to get to our port, so we move further. Hopefully we get there without any loss. And we go to turn 16. So this is the beginning of turn 16. We cannot enter the port during this turn, because we have to enter the port after turn 16. So from turn 17 we can enter the port. During this turn, what is the event? We will soon know it. A double two, white, black, and that means a double two, and that's this event. Mm-hmm. So here we have first Echo 4, we have the U-boat, Echo 4. So what is the event? Ark Royal, if the U-boat is in the zone, which is the case, roll a die. On the 1 to 3 the Ark Royal is sunk and we earn 2 victory points. We have to mark the Ark Royal then as sunk on the charge. So we have to roll 1 die for the U-boat. There it goes. And we have a 2, and that means that we sunk the Ark Royal. The Ark Royal must have been damaged or something from another battle, and we earned 2 victory points. So actually this is indicated over here. So now we have in total 3 plus 2, we have 5 victory points. And we also have to mark that the Ark Royal is sunk. We do that on the event chart using the yellow cubes. I think we need 3. First one is over here, but it's also applicable on the other events, like over here. Mark if the Ark Royal is sunk, then we can ignore this air attack event. And here there is also an Ark Royal Swordfish Plains. Here we also have to mark that the Ark Royal has been sunk. I don't think there is another event where the Ark Royal is involved. Okay, so this was the blue area, but we still have the orange area. Direct hit on ship guns. Where is our fleet? Is in Gulf 6. Gulf 6, and this is luckily outside this event zone. If we would have rolled, if we would have been in the zone and lost one firepower, this would have been a permanent loss of firepower of one of the two ships. Then we would have used one of these tokens to indicate the permanent reduction in firepower. But fortunately for us, we don't have to roll because we are outside the event zone. Okay, that means the event is over. We have to move forward. We cannot enter the port because we can only enter it after turn number 6. So we stop here in front of the port, and then we go to turn number 17, and now we are in a turn where we can enter the port. But first we have to do an event. We roll the dice, and this gives a white 6 and a black 5. White 6, black 5. This is this event. This is bombers, British bombers, and I think we are in that area. So not the U-boat. This one is at Echo 4. Although he's mentioned, if he would be in the blue zone, he would be involved, but it's not the case for him. He's outside the zone. But we are in Gulf 7. Gulf 7 is definitely inside the blue zone. So during air attack phase, roll 1 die to search. And at the roll of 1-3, the bombers will find the ships. So we first have to do a roll to determine if the bombers are finding our 2 ships. Okay, let's roll. 3, yes. Yes, they have found our ships. If found, roll 1 die per ship And U-boat, if the U-boat will be in the zone, this is not not the case, and it will be hit on 1-4.
Mm-hmm.
So per ship, so we first roll for the Bismarck. 6, so that's a miss. That's a miss. And now we have to roll for the Prince Eugen. And that's also a 6. That's also a miss. We are very lucky. Otherwise, we would have lost the Prince Eugen. Roll 1 die per ship. And with this roll, this event is also finished. And now we can move. And we do one move and we enter into the port of Brest. And then we go to the next turn, but the mission has stopped now. We are at the end and we have achieved the objectives. We have earned 5 victory points and we can mark this on the battle record for the second mission. The target was 3. So we have obtained 5 victory points and we also returned safely after round 16. Into port, we can mark the results with the cube. Bismarck was sunk, no. Game 1, yes. And we even managed to earn a medal because also the Prince Eugen came safely into port after turn 16, and for that we take a medal here. And all in all, we had a very good result on this mission, and this is how it is indicated. And now we could save this mission to continue another mission later on. So we are at the end of this playthrough. I hope it was interesting. It showed a lot of the game mechanics and it gives a pretty good idea of how the solitary game is played. I hope I didn't make any mistake. If I would have made any mistake, you can always make or leave a comment. I thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the game as much as I did. And see you on the next one.